Hello and happy Motivational Monday. I'm Sonya Jenkins. Hope you've had a good weekend. By now, you know that we lost two civil rights icons in one day, Reverend C.T. Vivian and Congressman John Lewis. Rest in peace. I was not only blessed to meet both civil rights leaders, but I got a chance to chat with them throughout the years in Atlanta, on the set of Selma, at my mentor Zernona Clayton's events, who is also a civil rights leader. I got a chance to mingle with two heroes. I featured my red carpet interview with Congressman John Lewis quite a few times, but there is no better time than now to share that interview again. And there is no better time for us to keep pressing forward and believing that we can make a difference. In this video, you'll also get to see some footage I took at a celebration for Congressman Lewis 5 years ago. There is nothing to it but to do it.
Such an impact in the African American community, civil rights, and what gives you the drive and the passion to just be as inspirational and as driven as you are?
Well, you know, I was deeply inspired by individuals like Martin Luther King Jr., Rosa Parks. I met Rosa Parks when I was 17, Dr. King when I was 18. Mm-hmm. I met W.E.B. Du Bois and others and teachers, and people just give you the push. Mm-hmm. I had a teacher when I was in about the third or fourth grade who said, "Read, my child, read, my child." And I tried to read everything. And I still try to read everything. Okay. And it's a different world, it's a better world, but we can still make it much better.
Exactly. And in this new age society where people, men are dragging their pants and things are just different, what advice or success tips would you give to younger people?
Well, I would say to young people, study your history, watch the film, the videos, or that period, and try to live with a sense of dignity and with a sense of pride. And I would say to young black men, pull your pants up, pull them up. We don't wanna see your shorts. And you know, pull them up for Barack Obama.
Amen.
And one day maybe some of them will be president, governor, mayors, great teachers, lawyers, engineers, actors. And make a contribution to the society.
I was also honored to attend the 75th birthday celebration for civil rights icon John Lewis in Atlanta 5 years ago, where his family, friends, and hundreds of guests from around the world celebrated him. Some of the guests in attendance included U.S. Ambassador Andrew Young, actress Alfre Woodard, singers Dionne Warwick, Jennifer Holliday, Regina Bell, just to name a few. There was also a special videotape message from President Barack Obama and former President Bill Clinton. In this video, Congressman Lewis shakes a leg to his favorite song, Happy, with several of his guests, including my dear friend, Cheyenne Webb Kreisberg, known as Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.'s smallest freedom fighter. She was only 9 years old when she attempted to cross the Edmund Pettus Bridge on the day that we know now as Bloody Sunday. I met Cheyenne on the set of Selma in Selma, Alabama, when I was a marcher in the film. Being a part of the Oscar-nominated film Selma had a great impact on my life, but more impactive have been the people I've met along the way, such as Congressman John Lewis, a warrior, a fighter, a marcher, an inspiration to us all. Congressman Lewis and Reverend C.T. Vivian paved the way during the civil rights movement. Now it's up to us to carry the torch and march on. I just want to end with a quote by Congressman John Lewis. "You must be bold, brave, and courageous, and find a way." to get in the way. Have a great week.
Here in Selma, Alabama, words can't explain how I feel today. It's the 50th anniversary of the march across the Edmund Pettus Bridge, all the way to Montgomery, for the Voting Rights Act. I'm Sonya Jenkins here in Selma, Alabama, 50th anniversary.